Hello, my name is Gerhard Welker, and in this video, I will present you our SAP S/4HANA Cloud 2108 release highlights for supply chain. First, I want to highlight the new Manage Physical Inventory Count app in inventory management. Let me demonstrate the application on my smartphone. I log on the SAP S/4HANA Cloud system as a warehouse clerk, open the SAP Fiori app Manage Physical Inventory Count, and check the scanner settings. The app allows barcode scanning of physical inventory counts with internal and external scanner devices. In this demo, the inbuilt device camera is used. Now I press the scan button and the device camera automatically scans the material number barcode. As a result, an uncounted physical inventory document is selected, which is due since a few days, and I'm entering the counted quantity as well as the count date. In addition, I use the device camera again, take a photo of the screw box, and upload the photo as an attachment. Saving of the document retrieves a warning message which calls me to check the input as the difference between counted quantity and booked inventory balance exceeds the tolerance range. After increasing the counting variance in the app settings, the warning disappears when saving the physical inventory document. Second, coming to transportation management, where we launch a brand new end-to-end solution which enables SAP S/4HANA Cloud Transportation Management to be used as a standalone planning system. So far, the so-called order-based transportation consolidation best practice scenario supports transportation execution and monitoring in SAP S/4HANA Cloud in connection with a decentralized transportation management system. Now, the new best practice scenarios for manual transportation planning in inbound and outbound processing enable manual planning with SAP S/4HANA Cloud and removes the need of an external transportation management system to create freight orders. How does it work? The purchase order-based transportation demands, so-called freight units, are built considering transportation constraints. Created freight units are planned using the transportation cockpit. Charges for transporting the cargo are calculated based on rates maintained in a released freight agreement. Based on the communication with the assigned carrier responsible for the execution of the transportation, relevant subcontracting status is reported. Inbound delivery creation is triggered from the freight order based on the consolidation information. Freight costs in the freight order are broken down. The aggregated freight costs of the order are shared to the delivery item level based on its gross weight. The arrival and check-in of the truck is reported. After completing the physical unloading process, the checkout and the departure of the truck is reported to enable the posting of accruals. After the confirmation of a freight order for posting, the system automatically posts the freight costs to financial accounting for accruals. During the posting process, freight orders can be monitored for any errors to resolve them. The invoice received from the carrier is finally verified against the costs calculated in the freight order. Finally, I want to draw your attention to warehouse management, which supports now mobile warehousing through a radio frequency framework, shortly called RF framework. This feature enables you to use radio frequency devices to carry out warehouse activities such as put away, picking, packing, and replenishment. The system guides warehouse operators through their daily tasks. They can scan barcodes to record and verify data such as storage bins, products, and handling unit numbers, or to enter pick quantities. With warehouse management, you have an out-of-the-box set of SAP GUI for HTML mobile RF screens for processing activities in a warehouse. If you want to learn more about supply chain as part of our SAP S/4HANA Cloud 2108 release, visit blogs.sap.com and read my blog. Also check out our new SAP S/4HANA Cloud community. Thanks for tuning in.